Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2 Enhanced Edition Shadows of Arm Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. Let's go get... Did this start twinkling again? Like, I just noticed it where, like, it wasn't... Never mind. Out of the corner of your eye, you know, technically this person is dead. See last episode. We could not resurrect, or raise dead, rather. We could not heal or do anything.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
We even tried flesh to stone, or stone to flesh, sorry. Was it? Oh.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Gathering. Make the noise. Make the noise. I'm listening for the noise. Huh, never mind.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Oh, you too? They got caught in a fireball. But, yeah, it was some friendly fire a little while ago. Doing Corgan's quest, I think. Yeah, he's beside himself. But that other one makes a strange noise here.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Hear that?
Stand back for justice.
Okay.
See battle bow. Run, make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
Getting in our way. You're making those weird bird noises. Who's making it now? You? Those people are so strange. Oh! He attacked! He rolled a 6.
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
In stereo. When did he attack? Were you trying to talk to him?
Bat kicking for goodness.
Or was it this guy who attacked? He left. Hi.
Where Minsk goes. Evil stands aside.
It's like a cat. You can't decide whether it wants to be in or out. So, I'm gonna stop messing around with them. And look for Jan Jansen or Jan Jansen. Jansen? What? I don't know. Alright. Oh, that's a cat. I'm like, what the hell is that? Hi! Is Jan Jan around? Oh there, friend. I have a fine barrel of wares for you to peruse if you but care to stop a moment. Very well, let me see what you have to sell. You're most gracious. Look upon the finest assortment of turnips in Athcatla. Oh, that's right, I forgot about the turnips. Red and gold from the south, even the blue turnips of the north, all fresh. They turn blue because they're freezing, that's why. So the conversation's going to be like this, and then this, and then... Are you trying to tell me that all you have to sell is turnips? And why not sell turnips? Delighting the palate of the young and old with flavors of distinction and subtlety, the turnip has so many uses it boggles the mind. I don't think young people like turnips. Why you have turnips... I think it's something like... Well, you have turnip stew, boiled turnips, turnip salad, turnip and eggs. You can string turnips together and make a turnip necklace. I'd rather have some bubblegum shrimp. I'm not really interested in turnips, really. A sad state to lack interest in something so wonderful. I think that Kylie can see within you, however, an eye for more adventurous things, yes? Well, yes, but turnips are not adventurous. My Uncle Fernbottom once had an eye for adventure. Finest looking gnome you ever saw in his shiny golden armor as he raised his sword on high. A wonderful memory, until he attracted a griffin with all that shiny armor. The griffin would have enjoyed a plate of turnips more than stringy old Uncle Fernbottom. Well, it depends if I think griffins are carnivores, aren't they? I don't even know. He put up quite the fight going down, not unlike a bad turnip, especially if you don't wash it in a spring. I've lost track of where I was going with this. Yes, adventure. I suppose a fine lady like yourself wouldn't be interested in a turnip necklace. You should seek out my cousin Jan. Yes, we are seeking him out, but for nothing having anything to do with turnips. A wonderful turnip seller, but one can't sell vegetables exclusively. He might have something more along your line of interest, or is he selling footstools now? And where might I find this Jan fellow? An awfully good question. He used to have a shop until that business with the pudding. Jan sells his wares from the streets, much as I do. A fine tradition. He's hard to miss. He's usually in the government district. Better coin there. Not many gnomes wandering the streets of Athcatla, anyway. Yes. Well, perhaps I'll try to find him. Good day to you. I think he's supposed to be inside the house, though, isn't he? Well, don't you forget now. Jan Jansen, he'll have... what a fine adventuring sort like yourself is looking for. Just tell him Cousin Kylie sent you. I won't. How about it? Tot. Is that a name?
Jump on Tot? My sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Or are you a tot? A skylight in the roof shines light through this hole into the basement. You're really, really ugly. And you're really rude and should be thrashed about. Oh, more people. Oh, this. Okay, I guess it is a name. We have Tot and Tat. Short for tattoo. Leave my kitty alone. I wasn't going to touch your cat. Shut up. I saw you looking at her. No, that was Boo. Okay, so Ma Jansen. I don't suppose you have any turnips you'd like to sell. You must be friends of Jan, garbed as you are. If he's not here, you might catch him in the government district selling turnips. He might even be downstairs in the garden. Probably, yes. Let's just look up here really quick, because I don't remember this. It was quite a while since we've been here. Okay. Same. Okay, so...
The bigger they are... the harder I hit!
History of Derpar and Var, yes. We got that in the first Baldur's Gate. Antidote. The color seems strange. Yeah, I don't think it's actually... working. Okay. We're done in here. Any more question mark things? I like to read the flavor text. Okay. We will go downstairs.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
There he is. And his Uncle Gerhardt. Turnip garden? Let's talk to Uncle first, why not?
Stand back for justice!
Where's that blasted chicken? Methinks he swiped me sausage. Alright.
Well, by Aunt Petunia's beard, a ghost from my past? Looking to buy some turnips, perhaps?
Thanks, but no thanks. I have sought you out to have you join my party. Adventuring, eh? I don't know. I'm making close to 6 gold pieces a week in this exciting field of black market veggies. What would people say? If it makes you happy, you can tell your friends that I've pressured you into joining. As Uncle Scratchy used to say, a true friend is a bald-faced liar. Let us depart then, my new companion. I have an itch to pepper a few hobgoblins with crossbow bolts. Oh, another crossbow user. Alright, let's go. Alright, so we're getting rid of Edwin. We only had him for that quest, same as Jan. I like Jan, though.
So is this to be it, then?
He didn't say his other little personality. Only a true fool would not realize my importance. Yes, we no longer have need of your services. Fine, if you ever come to your senses, as unlikely as they may be, where exactly would you like to meet me, Go wait for us at the Copper Coronet. If things change, we'll come meet you there. Dismissed. You know what I hate more than anything? Rancid turnips. No, wait just a minute. That's not quite true. More than I hate rancid turnips, I hate the creepy, crawly, flying, biting, swarming bugs that think just because a turnip's rancid that I don't want it anymore, and they're perfectly welcome to burrow into it and have wild parties with their other creepy, crawly friends. The worst is when they start to sing. Sing with glee at a decimated turnip. I hate them too, filthy insects. I hate them too, filthy turnips. I have no time for your jabber. He is funny, though. Truly, your observations fascinate me. Speak on, good gnome. How I do love a sympathetic audience. They tend to throw softer bricks. I got to thinking about those turnip-desecrating insects and just how much I hate them. And you know me, Sapphire. I don't really know you. I'm a man of moderation, so I considered the usual resources, but I just wasn't ready to eat all that dragonfly, and Kylie was full up that day as well. Then it hit me. Those insects aren't bad, just misguided. Probably from broken homes, and now I have given them a purpose in life. Allow me to demonstrate. What are we demonstrating? Hey!
Don't yell. I can hear you just fine.
You see, they're much like my acclaimed flasher master bruiser mates, but magically infested with termites and flying ants. Serves them right, the greedy buggers. Oh, and our foes too, of course. Jan, I'm going to kill you now. This won't make him hostile, right? I mean, not literally. Oh, I doubt that. For who will make you Flasher Master Swarmer mates if I am gone? Aha! I thought so. Stinger, you. Alright, so let's check him out. He can level up as well. And he has the following things. Probably read them. That's the thing he was mentioning. Flasher, Master, Bruiser, Mate. This is the ammunition for Jan's crossbow, the Flasher, Master, Bruiser. These skulls are filled with a special powder that does a little bit of damage and has a chance to stun an opponent. Saving throw versus spell will be stunned for 2 rounds. Same. Thaco plus 1. Damage is 1d2. 2 plus 1. That's stinky damage. Well, it's the stunning that we like. Right. And regular bolts. Well, no, these are... Yeah, these are regular bolts. What if we got you some better bolts? Oh, that's right, he has some. Oh, these aren't bolts, these are arrows. We had a lot more bolts for some reason. Oh right, there's that ammo pouch. Forgot about this thing. Probably in here. Oh. Wait. Oh, that's Dragomir's respite. I'm looking for the... Oh, this thing. Ammo belt. We'll give him bolts of biting. He's not going to be with us that long, so I don't think he's going to use it all up. Or use them all up. Okay, he's also got a flasher launcher. This is Jan Jansen's crossbow, and... Oh, wait, so this is part of ammo. Looks like 10 times? Or 10 times a day. I don't know. Or is it just a charged item? Yeah. Well, I guess we'll use this and then have him use the bolts of biting after that. Alright, so this is Jan Jansen's crossbow, and as such, its complexity... And such is its complexity that only he can use it. Likewise, only he can make the special ammunition is capable of firing. Substantial tinkering on this launcher has made it specially accurate. So Thaco is plus one. Speed factor is 3, so that's pretty quick. Pretty quick for a crossbow, right? Speed factor 3. Oh, 4? Never mind. It's a little faster. It always seems like he's so slow to, throw a crossbow bolt. How about a sling? How quick is that? Speed factor 5. Okay, never mind. Just because I'm watching him, I'm sure. Okay, so... Jansen Adventure Wear? Jansen brand metal repellent adventure wear. Patent pending. This strange armor is made of a foreign material, very supple but strong to the touch. Designed by and for Jan Jansen, only he may wear it. The armor does not give any bonuses to the base armor class, but it does grant a 25% resistance to all physical damage and an additional +5 bonus to Jan's armor class against missile weapons. Jan may also cast spells while wearing this armor. In addition, the armor is stylish. Note, dry clean only. Equipped abilities is physical damage resistance plus 25%. Armor class is 9, but 4 versus missile. We can take this stuff off. Okay. Jansen Techno Gloves. Jansen brand Techno Thieving Gadgetizer Gloves. Trademark. This set of thieving tools gives Jan an additional bonus to both his lock picking and pickpocketing. He is the only one who can use it. Oh, you can use the gloves, as no one else quite has the knack of it. Oddly, he seems to be able to actually cast spells while wearing the things. Must be because they got style. Open locks and pickpockets are plus 20%. Oh, he's an illusionist thief. I thought he was just a thief. Jansen spectroscopes. Jansen brand micro-macro spectroscopes, official spectroscopes of the Purple Brotherhood. Another one of Jan Jansen's inventions, these glasses allow Jan to detect invisibility once per day. They also give Jan an additional 25% to his detect and disarm traps abilities. Various lenses on the contraption increase Jan's ability to detect illusions by 20%. The style of the spectroscopes is so obvious it hardly needs to be mentioned. Okay, so we got find traps plus 25%, detect illusion plus 20%. He has immunity to blindness. He can detect invisibility once per day in a 15-foot radius. And I've been interchangeably saying Jan Jansen or Jan Jansen because I'm not sure how to say it, so at least I'm right some of the time. Definitely wrong some of the time as well. So, information, and we'll level him up. When asked about his past, Jan stops tinkering with his gadgets and states that, despite all claims to the contrary, turnip beer has wondrous medicinal properties in addition to its fine taste. How illuminating. Okay, leveling up. So he's an illusionist level 7 and thief level 8. Leveling him up, give him proficiency in what? He already has a crossbow. I'm going to have him just use a crossbow. Hold on a second. That seems fair. I'll probably give him... something. Let's see. Needs something just in case he needs to enter melee for some reason. Give him Neb's dagger. Maybe we shouldn't tell him he used it, cause he'll we can't use that at all. Guess cause he's part illusionist, so we need to give him like a staff or something like that. Oh well, could have been great. Like, don't tell him it's from a serial killer of children. Who would want to use that, you know? You just look at it in horror. It says thief cannot use. Oh, mage cannot use. Okay. Not giving him the staff of curing. Thief, mage. Staff of air plus 2. Can also cast sleep cloud, yeah. We'll give that to him for now anyway. I get to take it back. Alright, so we're leveling up. He has a staff. Maybe we'll give him points in staves. We don't have that. Oh, quarterstaff, he's already good with. Alright, so single weapon style, I guess. And then, 100 for skills, nice. Alright, we'll make pickpockets at even 100. We'll make fine traps at even 100 as well. Should we? Wait a second. I was going to put it all in Detect Illusion, but... maybe not. Because I've only got moved silently to... 55. Wow, 100 points still goes quickly. Okay, so let's put Fine Traps down to 90. And Hide and Shadows there. Put Open Locks at 90. Because, I mean, we still got Yoshima with us. We'll put Hide and Shadows there. Okay. So we got pickpocket 60. Leaving that alone. Don't pickpockets very often or at all. Open Locks and Fine Traps at 90. Move silently. Hide and Shadows at 55. And Detect Illusion at 70. What if we make... oh, I can't go down lower. Never mind. Done. So he is a level 11 illusionist and level 12 thief. Alright, so now... I wanted to hit that to go right to the spellbook, but no. Aerie says... I wish someone would say his name out loud so I know how to say it. Jan, how come you're always telling stories? Because they're true, every last one of them. Even the one about my great-grandfather slaying the dragon. A dragon? Really? Well, not really, but close. He thought it was a dragon. He was experimenting with glass, grinding it down to make prisms and lenses, you see, because his daughter, my grandmother, was so cross-eyed that, until she was 12 years old, all she ever saw of the world was the nose in the center of her face. You never had that problem as a child, did you? Me? Oh, no, not that. Good. I wouldn't recommend it to anyone. So my great-grandfather had put together a great series of lenses and prisms. I think 12 in all, and attached them to a leather helm he had, the strap of which always chafed under the chin. Then, all of a sudden, a cloud passed in front of the sun. Oh my, was it the dragon? No, no, it happened precisely as I tell it to you now. A cloud passed in front of the sun, and my great-grandfather looked up from his work so quickly that a dragonfly got caught between two of the prisms over his left eye and clung there for dear life. Of course, you can't imagine the hullabaloo this caused, my dear. No, I can imagine it just fine, Mr. Jansen. There he was, throwing all his tools and turnips into the distance, where he assumed he his greatly magnified adversary to be, and he was running and hollering and telling us to get in the house while he tried to lure the ravaging beast into the backyard of our south side neighbors, against whom he had always held a grudge. Whatever happened? What do you expect happened? We just assumed that he hadn't been digging his herbs and berries again and all wrestled him to the ground, ruining his precious lens helm in the process, I'm afraid. It took us a good hour to calm him down and figure out what the truth of the matter had been. Now, do you know what the moral of the story is, Airy? Always wipe your lenses? That will do nicely. I hadn't come up with one for this story yet. And your grandmother, did she make her a new lens hat so she could finally see? What? Oh, no, no. It was an idea doomed to fail, I'm afraid. 2 years later, she lost her nose in a bizarre harvest accident, and she's been seeing just fine ever since. Okay. That's a thing. Okay, so we got identify... it's funny, we've got it all memorized, as you see here. Chromatic orb, color spray, is it easily saved? I'm going to take out, plus this, it's friendly fire, oh, wrong side. It's a friendly fire type of thing. Reflected image. I suppose so. I don't think it's as good as mirror image. Yeah, it's just one copy, right? I'll take out identify. It'll be a magic missile thrower. Does he have mirror image? Because then... Well, he has blur. Oh, and mirror image. Okay, if you have mirror image, you don't need this one then. So... I guess another another magic missile. Okay. So he's got... Well, could you mirror image and blur yourself? I guess so. Invisibility, Melf's Acid Arrow. Okay, so I'm going to take out Blur. I'm going to throw in another mirror image. We have Detect Invisibility. He has that with his, with this though, doesn't it? Detect once per day. Okay. So that's why that's not memorized. And I'm assuming invisibility is good, Melf's is good, two mirror image, and then Melf's here. Okay, so we've got invisibility 10-foot radius, that's pretty good. Lightning bolt, I tend not to use. Remove magic, okay, we'll keep that one. We got haste, flame arrow. Alright, so flame arrow, two hastes. Improved invisibility, right? Yep. And stone skin. Polymorph self. Greater malison. Confusion. Another improved. Okay. So we got Chaos, Domination, Hold Monster, and Shadow Door. That spells I really use that often. I don't know if I'm going to use any of those. So this, he knows true sight and mislead, but has no slots. Level 70, knows project image. That's it. Okay. Oh, he's talking more now. I've made a discovery, and I wanted to be sure you were the first to know about it, considering how nice you've been to me since I bailed you out of that little run-in with the law. Who's he talking to? Talking to me? I know you're as much a fan of quality footwear as the next biped, or even the last, but if you don't mind my saying so, those sleeves you have your toes in are looking rather threadbare, and we can't have a big woman about town leaving threadbare footprints. A big woman? I've been pondering the problem of a good pair of boots and how they are at least the seventh most important factor in making a good first impression, so I've pursued some magical lines of inquiry that I think are going to pay off handsomely in a new set of arch-supporting marvels. So I present to you, free of charge and with no further obligation, your newest pair of boots infused with even newer magical powers to dazzle and impress. Be polite, Sapphire. Wave hello. Wave hello to the boots. Hello, boots. Welcome to my feet. Do these boots do anything special? Why, the boots of Jansen kind? Of course they do. You'll find out all about it soon after you put them on. Just be polite to the boots at all times and you'll get along fabulously, I'm sure. And whatever you do, don't talk down to them. They hate that. literally in the direction, so I have to take them off with the top. I'm not gonna talk to them. Okay, whatever. He really gave that to me. Okay. He really gave it to me. Boots of Jansen or Jansen kind. Jan Jansen, noted gnomish researcher, scientist, and scholar, wanted to create footwear that would be not only stylish and comfortable, but provide an air of sophistication and refinement to the wearer. He looked no further than his own reflection for inspiration. When activated by a double time march in place, the wearer... Really? A double time march in place? The wearer of these boots is transformed into a very good likeness of Jan himself. Whether this will help the wearer understand Jan any better remains to be seen. Huh? It changes its intent to look like him? Jan presented these boots as a gift to Sapphire shortly after he finished their construction, which may indicate they have never been field tested. These boots can transform the wearer into a Jansen-esque male gnome for 10 turns. Okay. I'll hang on to them. But I want to keep using my armor class plus 5 versus missile attack boots. Thank you. What else do you have to say? We've been going for over a half hour. I haven't even started his quest yet. Nothing else to say? Okay, let's go.
See battle, Bo! Run, Bo, run! Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
See if Ma says anything new. Oh, Jan and his friends have come to visit. Welcome to our humble home.
Bat kicking! Not exactly. For goodness!
You must gather your party before venturing forth.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Oh, you're fine enough, I suppose.
Well, if it isn't my dear cousin Jan. Cousin Kylie, how goes the turnip business? Better than some days, Jan. Your good friend here didn't see the romance of the turnips, however, and didn't buy one. Well, I shall have to remedy that and sample one of these succulent morsels. That's better. Which reminds me, cousin, that you simply don't visit home enough. I know. I agonize over that fact constantly. Don't you patronize me, Jan Jakobar Jansen. What kind of gnome doesn't visit his home once in a while? You know, Kylie, I'll have to go right now and think about that. Humph. Thanks for the turnip, cousin. Termish, wasn't it? Fresh as a Kalashite belly dancer. Off we go, Sapphire. Now, from what I've read, trying to keep it spoiler-free as possible for myself, we have to wait 15 to 17 days for his quest to begin. In the meantime, I think if we go to the Five Flagons, someone will give him a special boot. That's kind of cheating, but... Like, how would I know that? But I'm interested in seeing the content nonetheless. It's probably a boot that I won't use? I mean, possibly. So... What the docks, I think they're at? It's either docks or bridge district. Yeah, I think it's bridge district. Okay. What's that to the side? Look at that. It's like...
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
We can see part of the buildings here. Huh. It's funny how just this part is revealed. Alright, let's go to the bridge district. Somewhere. Yeah. Bridge. Bridge over...
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
Bridge over... Faerûn waters? I don't know.